The average Greek pisses off three gods a year is actually statistically incorrect. Odysseus of Ithaca, who manages to piss off everyone he comes across on his 10-year journey home, is a statistical anomaly and should not have been counted.
I'm a prophet!
What?
Prophet! Prophet! I prophesy! I have sight! I see!
She don't see us? You see me?
Yeah. Yes, I see you. You see me?
Hell yeah, I see you. Both of us sitting here look like two big Barneys.
Are you coming home?
Oh yeah, I love rowdy music. Who are you rocking out to? Let me guess. Biscuit?
No.
Okay. Korn?
No.
System?
No.
Rammstein?
No.
Slipknot?
No.
Goddamn, you gotta hand it to him, Deb. He knows a lot of bands.
It's too many bands.
Disturbed?
No.
Papa Roach?
No.
Manson?
No.
Marilyn, not Charles.
What?
Marilyn, not Charles.
No.
Okay, a little more obscure. Seven Dust.
No.
Deftones?
No.
Soulfly?
No.
Godsmack?
No.
Jesus, all right, just tell me what you're into. What do you listen to? Just tell me.
Post Malone?
Post Malone?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I've heard some of their shit.
Tell me why! Fuck you! Get the fuck away from me! Yes, you can. Tell me why. I never wanna hear you say, fuck that cop anyway. Fuck you! Piece of shit.
I'll have to play. If you think you're getting away, I will prove you wrong. I'll take you all the way. Boy, just come along. Hear me when I say, hey.
Been around. Every now and then I get a little bit terrified, and then I see the look in your eyes.
Turn around.
With extra cheese.
Extra cheese.
And hold the tomato sauce.
Hold the tomato sauce.
And hold the crust.
Hold the crust. Hey, Jimmy, give me a cheese with nut.
Nothing.
Slut, what is the future of my son?
He's gonna kill you and marry his mom.
What?
Yeah, actions meet consequences. Now get the fuck off my property.
You, hapless shepherd.
Oh, fuck.
Take my fetus and yeetus it off of this cliff.
Okay.
3 hours later.
Yo, King of Corinth. Some weird-ass man just told me to kill his child. You want it? Yeah. I could do with a son. Sick, here you go.
18 years later.
I am now a grown man. You are adopted. Okay, who's my dad? Sick, okay, I'm gonna go find him then.
Move, slut!
Why would you talk to a stranger like that? No, fuck you.
Then I will kill you.
Oh yeah, I'd love to see your wrinkly motherfucking ass try.
Ah!
That's the worst battle cry I've ever heard.
Ah!
Damn, that's really all it took? Fuck, okay.
Halt, strange traveler, for you must answer my riddles 3.
Okay.
What walks on 4 legs in the morning, 2 in the evening, and wait, fuck.
Or, I know where you're going with this. It's man?
Yeah.
Oh my god, you've totally saved us, and my husband, like, weirdly died on the road with no explanation, so I'll marry you now. Ah, sweet, big titty milf.
3 years later.
Hey, does anyone know why everyone in my city is now dying of the plague? Yep, I got an answer for you. You're not gonna like it, though. Okay. You, fun fact, actually ended up marrying your mother and you killed your father, so... tough. Ooh, yeah, that is really tough. Mom? Ooh, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go hang myself now. That feels like the best course of action to take at this moment in time. Alright, well, yeah, I guess there's only one thing for me to do then. Yep, blind myself and wander the countryside for the rest of my life. So, alright, daughter, let's go!
I could fix her. Yeah? Well, I could accept her as she is. You don't like the murder? Grow up. The atrocities are part of her, and I've decided they're funny.
He was a great leader.
His hands bore the blood of thousands of children.
Slay.
Let's talk Persephone, Hades, and Demeter, and often the villainization that happens to poor Demeter, as well as the romanticization of Hades and Persephone and that relationship there. It is often treated like a love story, and Demeter treated as an overprotective helicopter mom, and that is simply not the case. When people argue for the romanticization of Hades and Persephone and the relationship and loving each other so deeply, it is often at the expense of Demeter, and they will argue that there are multiple hymns, myths to draw from where we see them loving each other and Demeter being a bad mother. And that's just not the case. There is only one singular origin story for Hades and Persephone, and that is the hymn to Demeter. Keyword: Demeter. It is about the mom, not Hades and Persephone. People will argue that Persephone went willingly, that Persephone ate the pomegranate seeds on her own to stay with Hades because she loved him so much. And we, people who worship or work with Hades and Persephone, have to come to the realization that's really just not the case and is not supported through the myths. In the myth, it is stated on multiple occasions that Persephone was unwilling, that she shouted and screamed out, that she ran back into her mother's arms. It's a story about a mother who loves her daughter so much that goes to the ends of the earth to get her daughter back. A point in history where this myth is coming from, when daughters were married off and then often never saw their mothers again. It was a story for mothers. Hades and Persephone even barely speak within the hymn to Demeter. It is mostly Demeter also speaking with a mortal queen, going through the emotions of how she is practically killing the earth through her sadness and her sorrow and her grief and taking away all plant life and the ability to feed themselves. The hymn to Demeter gave mothers everywhere hope that they could keep their daughters and their children in their lives even after marriage. Now, there are plenty of lines within the hymn to Demeter where we can see Hades' actual love and wanting to give everything that he can to Persephone. There is arguments to be made that there is love there, at least when it comes from Hades to Persephone. And UPG, many of us agree that Persephone and Hades have come to love and appreciate and respect each other over time. But it cannot be said that it was that way in the beginning. And we need to accept that.
I'll give you three reasons. One, she's a female. Two, she's not a boy. And three, and most importantly, she's a girl!
Achilles, I need you to take a look at this. Why are you crying?
Because I miss Patroclus. He used to call me that.
What, Achilles?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's your fucking name.
Don't yell at me. You're being so insensitive right now.
Okay, yeah. I am officially done. I cannot deal with this gay shit anymore, and I'm gonna get on a boat back to Ithaca, and I'll see you all in 30 years. Have fun.
The grave.
In the hell are these?
Oh yeah, apparently they're called Roman blinds.
Then what's a Greek blind?
Oedipus with his eyes gouged out? Never mind, that's a blind Greek.
Bro!
Now that I've kidnapped you and brought you to the underworld, you are my bride. No. What do you mean, no? I asked Zeus, he gave me permission. What do I mean, no? I mean, no! I want to live with my mom! What did you think was going to happen? You were going to kidnap me and I was going to be like, oh my god, yes, I love you so much, let's get married forever. No, you fucking idiot. God, this place is a shit show. Okay, well, your mom's here. Just eat these pomegranate seeds before you go as an apology? Ugh, fine. You fucking dirtbag, you tricked me! Now I have to come back here for half the year? You're really hot. I cannot believe you run an entire realm like this. You know what? I'm taking over. Move. Get off your throne. Okay, yes, ma'am. You're an idiot. You're a tolerable idiot. I'll stay, but me and my mom are gonna shit talk you as soon as I get back. Fair enough.
Good day. I'm Bob the Necromancer, and today we're doing an unboxing.